Martha Johnson, Martha Ladley, and Mark Gane from Martha and the Muffins. Welcome to Countdown. Martha is a fairly unusual name. Do you find it confusing having two Marthas in the band?
I don't think we can tell each other apart, can we?
When you introduce yourself, they always say, "Oh, you are Martha." And I have to explain, inevitably, yes, I am Martha, but there is another Martha. So it gets a little bit confusing.
It's sometimes. Odd because I was the only one in the band at the beginning. And Martha Ladley joined the band about 6 months after we had started. And it was just a coincidence that her name was Martha as well. And that's what's led to the confusion.
Right. So where does the muffin part of the name come from?
The muffin part of the name came in because we couldn't decide on a name at all over the course of the summer that we were getting together. And we had about 2 weeks to go before our first gig, and a name had to go on the poster. And there was a very heavy punk scene going at the time in Toronto, and we weren't a part of that, and we didn't like the sort of posing that a lot of bands were doing at the time with punk imagery, so we went the exact opposite and picked something that was really wimpy, and Muffin couldn't have been any wimpier, so we put Martha in the front of it, and that's how it came about, really.
You've got a single out in Australia called Echo Beach. You wrote that, Mark.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, is there actually a place in Canada called Echo Beach?
Doesn't exist, to my knowledge. It's quite a fiction, really. It's just a state of mind. The song deals with a state of mind, really, that when one has a really lousy job, you tend to go back to a place you've been that has been quite enjoyable. And I think everybody has a place like that in their mind, and that's really what the song deals with.
It's funny, though, because they ran a contest in Canada on the radio. People were asked to write in and say if they knew where Echo Beach was. And apparently they came up with about 8 different locations throughout Canada and upper state New York. So there are actually quite a number of Echo Beaches, but you didn't know about that when you wrote the song.
No.
Between the three of you, you write all the material, don't you?
That's right, yeah.
Yeah. Which of you writes what part? Or do you write songs by yourselves and then
Yeah.
The stuff that I've done, I've written music and lyrics on my own, except for there's one song that's on the new album that it's going to be released in England very shortly, that was written with the sax player in the band, Andy Hawes.
And Saigon as well.
Yeah, but that was mostly written by somebody else, and I just added a bit to it. It was mostly someone else's song, but generally I write music and lyrics.
Mm. Mark and I have collaborated on a number of the songs on the Metro Music album, and in that case, music, and I've written the lyrics. And when you write on your own, you write all on your own, don't you?
All by my
the style of music.
I can't really categorize it, and everybody has trouble doing it, and we've never tried to.
It's a bit easy to just put the tag of new wave on it, isn't it?
The new wave is sort of a dying phrase, I think, too, though.
Yeah. What did somebody call it? You once called it electric music. That's good.
That doesn't really describe it at all.
We plug in most of our instruments. So.
Except our voices.
Somebody else once called it intellectual surf music, which I quite like.
Is there any plans to go to Australia, to tour Australia?
Oh, that would be great. I've never been there. I'd love to go.
Yeah, we'd really
like
to.
We'd like to go, sure. We'll go anywhere.